Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, because it neither sees nor knows it. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me because I live and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning to everyone. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat.
Good morning, Father.
And first, happy Mother's Day to all our mothers here. Okay? Lakpakan natin ang ating mga nanay. At pakibati po, no? Again, no? Kung nabati na ninyo, batiin nyo ulit ngayon. Mama, happy Mother's Day. Okay. In a special way, we thank God for them. We thank God, no, for the love that they have showed us. Because the love of the mother, through the love of the mother, we experience God's love. It's true. They say that's the closest love to God's love is a mother's love. Because the love of mothers, the love of a mother for her child is pure, is self-giving, selfless, and faithful. Kapag yung nanay nagmahal sa kanyang anak, it's pure. No? It has no other intention than to bring out the best for her child. Likewise, it is selfless. It is always willing to sacrifice herself for the sake of her child. And that love is also faithful because she will love her child even at her worst, at the worst, no? Even at our worst, no? Our mother will love us. So there is faithfulness in the love of a mother. And that is why that reveals to us, that makes us experience the very love of God to us, which is also pure, which is also selfless, which is also faithful. And so we love our mothers, our mother, and we love God because of the kind of love that they have shown us, they have let us experience. And so, if we have experienced much love from our mother, from God, the challenge, the invitation now of our gospel, this time, is that we show our love. We give love. That is why we heard Jesus telling us, "If you love me, keep my commandments. Show to me that you love me. Express your love to me." How? By keeping my commandments. In the Gospel of John, that's the only proof that Jesus is asking us to show our love to Him. No, hindi lang salita, but by keeping His commandments. In other words, the measure of our love for Jesus, of our love for God, is how much we obey God's commandments. And when we look at the word obedience comes from two Latin words, ab audire. And audire means to listen. So in the word obedience, nakapaloob dun yung salita ng pakikinig. And that's very true. We cannot obey if we don't know how to listen. Makakasunod lang tayo, makakatalima lang tayo kapag tayo ay marunong makinig. And so that's the very first commandment of the Lord that He handed on to Moses. The first commandment is not immediately, love God above all, above everything, with all your heart, with all your mind. May mas nauna doon. Which the Jews, no, in the Old Testament would faithfully recite every day, morning in the evening. That's the famous prayer, the Shema. And it tells there, no, hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore, you shall love the Lord your God with all your mind, with all your soul, and with all your heart. So the very first act of love is to hear. That's the very first commandment of God. Hear, listen, makinig kayo. Because by hearing, we can obey. By listening. And when we don't listen, we will not be able to obey. So that's the first thing we reflect on. The first act of love is by way of listening. And it's not just listening by sounds, so, with the use of our ears. Although that's the basic to listening. When we love someone, we listen to that person. No? Kapag hindi na natin mahal ang isang tao, napapagod na tayong pakinggan siya. Hindi na natin siya pinapakinggan. And we can also experience that. No? Kapag hindi na tayo pinapakinggan ng taong nagsasabi sa atin na mahal tayo, you better doubt that kind of love. Okay? Kapag hindi na pinagpapahalagahan yung nararamdaman mo, hindi na pinapakinggan yung opinion mo, okay? Wala ka ng tinig sa kanyang buhay, then that's a clear sign, no? That the love also is fading. Because listening is valuing the presence of the person. And that is a way of loving. Okay? Kapag kasama mo, no, hindi ka pinapansin, salita ng salita, hindi ka pinapakinggan, di ba, dead makalang, no? So parang hindi ka na nun mahal kasi hindi ka pinapakinggan. No? Wala siyang tinig sa iyong buhay. Hindi niya pinagpapahalagahan yung presensya mo. Hindi siya nakikinig sa iyo. It's very important. Listening. When we listen to someone, it means we value the presence of that person. It means we love that person. Yet the deeper kind of listening, not just listening through the ears, but also listening from the heart. Because when we love, even without unspoken words, we can hear the person we love. Kahit walang sinasabi sa atin, we can understand if the one we love is sad, is in pain, is going through something, is in need of our presence, of the assurance of our love. We know if the person we love is happy, very inspired or joyful, nababasa natin, napapakinggan natin, because our heart is close to the heart of the person we love. And so even without spoken words, we hear, napapakinggan natin, kasi nagmamahal tayo. Okay. Similarly, in our relationship with God, even if we don't hear God's word being proclaimed constantly in our life, no, sa misa lang naman natin napapakinggan, no, pinapahayag ang salita ng Diyos. But if we have love for God, then we can hear also His voice in our life. We can hear God's voice speaking to us when we are sick, when we are in pain, when we are happy, when we are victorious, when we are suffering. We can hear the voice of God because we love God. That's the fruit of love. We become so familiar with God's ways. We become familiar with God's voice that we are able to hear Him in every situation of our life. Kung wala tayong, kulang na tayo sa pagmamahal natin sa Panginoon, hindi na din natin siya napapakinggan sa ating buhay. Okay. So listening is a way of loving. It's the first act of loving. Okay. And then the second act of loving is doing. Okay. The purpose of listening is that so that we can obey, no? Para tayo ay makatalima. Para tayo ay makasunod. Because when God speaks to us, that word of God is always creative. Meron siyang nais na ating tugunan, na ating gawin. And this in the gospel, it tells us, if you love me, keep my commandments. Gawin mo. Do my commandments. Be obedient to my commandments. And what are the commandments of Jesus? We can recall in our gospel also that among the many commandments, Jesus summed them into two interrelated commandments. What are they? Love God above all and love your neighbor as yourself. That's the summary of all the laws and the prophets. Love of God and love of others. And Jesus even elevated the love of others into a higher form of love when Jesus said, love one another as I have loved you. Because then, Jesus gave us a new standard of loving others. Hindi na lamang kung paano natin minamahal yung ating sarili. But the measure of loving others becomes the way how Jesus loved us. So ganoon tayo inuutusan magmahal, no? Kung paanong ipinakita sa atin ni Jesus yung pagmamahal. That love comes in the form of being forgiving to those who have offended us, being understanding, being merciful to others, of praying for our enemies, praying for those who hurt us, those who have persecuted, those who have who are persecuting us perhaps, being extending help to those who are in need, being generous to others, sacrificing for the sake of love. Those are the acts of love that Jesus showed us, that Jesus did, and now He is asking us to do the same. Love, keep my commandments. Love as I did. So that's the second act of love. From listening to doing. Then the third act of love that will show our love to God is by way of repeating. Okay, you listen again. You do again. Because that tells us that love must be constant. Love must be consistent. Our faithfulness to the Lord must be consistent. Hindi lang one time, big time. No, yung ating pagpapakita ng pagmamahal or seasonal, occasional. Sometimes I am faithful to God. Other times, free day yon, no? So I can be unfaithful. When we truly love someone, our love to that person is consistent, is faithful. No? We listen to that person. We are sensitive to what the person, how our beloved wants that we love him or her. Ganun kasi yung nagmamahal, no? We don't impose the way we want. But we allow the person we love to speak to us kung paano natin siyang dapat mahalin. That's why listening is important. Okay? And that must be a consistent act. Likewise, doing, expressing our love to others, to persons who we say we love, must also be consistent. Patuloy nating pinapakita, pinapadama yung pagmamahal natin sa mga taong sinasabi nating minamahal, no? Minamahal natin ang ating magulang, hindi lamang kapag Mother's Day. Okay? But we express that love every day of our life. I saw a meme, no, sa internet. Merong nanay na binato niya yung kanyang anak, no? Sabi niya doon, ang haba-haba ng post mo sa FB, no, tungkol sa Mother's Day, hindi naman kita mautusan sa bahay. No, sometimes we only good in words, no? But no, the real expression of love is that we do acts of kindness, acts of sacrifices for the one we love. So that must be constant repetition, no? It must be repeated. So these are the three acts of love: listening to God, doing, no, expressing our love to Him, loving as Jesus did, and repeating, being consistent. So what do we have? LDR. LDR. Well, we mean by LDR, no, common ano natin, is long distance relationship. But when we desire to love God, that will not be a long distance relationship. Long distance relationship. Because God is near us. We can listen to God because He speaks to us at every moment of our life. He speaks to us when we are in pain. He speaks to us when we are sick, when we are happy, when we are joyful, when we are victorious. We can always listen to God because He is near. He even speaks to the people around us, to our experiences in our situation. And we can express our love to God because He is near. When we love others in the name of our love for Jesus, then that's the love that we show. That love we show is the love we have for Jesus. By putting love in everything we do, loving others as Jesus did, then that becomes our concrete proof of love for God. He is near. And we can fulfill that commandment of the Lord constantly, faithfully, because the Holy Spirit has been sent to us. The Holy Spirit is with us to help us to be faithful with our love, to be pure, to be selfless in our life. Because on our own, no, we cannot love faithfully. We cannot love purely. We cannot love selflessly. But the promise of Jesus in the gospel, I will send to you the Holy Spirit. I will not leave you orphans. So the Holy Spirit is here to assist us in making our love constant and faithful. So God is not far. When we desire to express our love to God, it's not long-distance relationship. We can listen to Him. We can express, we can do, express our love to God by loving others. And we can repeat again and again, we can be constant in our expressions of love if we allow the Holy Spirit to always empower us, to always teach us how to love as Jesus did. So that's how we can love the Lord. That's our love LDR with God. Amen.